Welcome to this video tutorial, one of many in a series designed to get you up and running with Leapfrog. This video is part 1 of 4 discussing Drillhole data in Leapfrog. In this video, I'm going to cover importing and visualizing Drillhole data. Drillhole data in Leapfrog is made of three different file types: the caller file, the survey file, and interval files. In this case, there are three interval files: geology, weathering, and contamination. The caller file defines the location of the drill hole at surface. Caller files require at least four columns: a hole ID column and the three coordinates, the easting, the northing, and the elevation. We recommend the caller table also has a total depth column, which Leapfrog uses to run some internal validation. Additional columns, such as the completed date or the drill hole type, are also welcome. The survey file defines the orientation of the drill hole at certain depths. The survey table must contain columns for hole ID, depth, dip, and azimuth. For straight drill holes, only one row is necessary. However, typically there are multiple records for one drill hole. Interval tables contain any downhole data you may have for the drill hole. Interval table files must have a column for hole ID, the from depth and the to depth, and one or more columns of measurements. Measurements can include grade, lithology, alteration, or any other required numeric or categorical values. If different types of data, for example, lithology and grade, have different interval lengths, they will need to exist in separate interval tables. You can import as many interval tables as necessary into your project. Now that we have an understanding of what's required for importing drill hole data, let's see how it's done. I'll start by right-clicking the drill hole data folder near the top of the project tree. As you can see, there are three options available. Import drill holes allows you to import drilling from text files such as a CSV, text, ASCII, or DAT file. Import drill holes via ODBC allows you to import drilling from any database that runs an ODBC interface. Import drill holes via acquire allows you to import drill holes by connecting directly to an acquire database. In this session, I'll import drill holes from a CSV file. I will start the import by browsing for the caller file. I'll select the caller file and click open. Leapfrog will automatically select the survey and geology tables, as these were located in the same folder as the callers and have names that are picked up as keywords by Leapfrog. In this case, I will need to manually select the contamination file as well as the weathering file. Click import to bring in the files you've selected. This opens the Import Drill Holes window with a preview of the data Leapfrog has read from your caller table. When importing and previewing drill hole data, the required columns are marked in green, and any additional columns we choose to bring in will be marked in orange. Leapfrog works through the files being imported one at a time. Progress is shown here at the top of the window. The file name in bold is the one currently being displayed, in this case, the caller file. If we look over here, we can see it is possible to choose the coding you would like Leapfrog to use when importing drill hole data. By leaving the auto encoding option selected, Leapfrog will select the most suitable encoding type. However, if there are uncommon international characters in your drill hole data, select the character encoding from the drop-down and find the encoding type that matches your data. You can also change the time and date formats, as well as the rules for imported CSV characters. For the caller table, all the required columns have been selected automatically based on the header of each column. For the caller table, you can see that all the required columns have been selected based on the header of each column. We can see they've been selected because they show up in green. There are additional columns to the right of the table that have not been automatically selected, and now we can choose whether or not we wish to add them to our project. When you're importing Drillhole data into Leapfrog, it is important to identify which columns will be helpful in the modeling process and which ones won't. We recommend only importing the columns that will be necessary for modeling and leaving the rest not imported. The initial import sets up the Drillhole data table structure for the rest of the project. Importing unnecessary columns at the beginning will require those columns to exist in any reloaded or appended data you wish to add later on. Also, these unnecessary columns may increase processing time in the project. Fortunately, it is easy to add additional columns of data or even whole data tables later on if you discover that you need them. This will be covered in Part 4 of the Drillhole Data series. In this case, we are going to import the Drillhole Type column as well as the Completed Date column. To import an additional column of data into Leapfrog, you can either select the Not Imported drop-down under the File Data table, or we can select the Not Imported option in the Column Summary, and we will be provided with the same options. For tables with many columns, it's frequently easier to deal with them in the Column Summary part of the import window. As we can see, there are a number of different types of data that we can import into Leapfrog. Up at the top, we have a Category option, and that is for any non-numeric data or categorical data that we wish to bring in and model in Leapfrog. In this case, that's what I'm going to select for my drill type. For the completed date, we can see that there's also a date option for import. You'll notice when I've selected to import the drill type and completed columns, they have shown up as orange. This represents they were user-defined as opposed to required. The next table we're going to see is the survey table. As we can see, Leapfrog's properly identified the whole ID, depth, and dip columns, but has wrongly identified the azimuth column. We can simply switch columns by clicking the not imported of the correct column and selecting azimuth. Now that we're done with this table, we can click next. We can see in the geology table, Leapfrog has identified the whole ID, the from and to depth, as well as the simple lith column. However, we're also going to import the strat column. You'll notice when we click the drop-down, we have three options up at the top that might be considered quite similar. The options of lithology and category are functionally identical within Leapfrog. The reason you have two options is because you might not necessarily wish to call, say, an alteration column, for example, a lithology, so it's been given the other option of category. In this case, however, we're dealing with a strat sequence, and so we can call that a lithology. One data type to be aware of is text. Data imported as a text cannot be modeled with in Leapfrog. An example of a table you might import as a text table would be a description or a summary column. You would never want to import your lithology or your weathering or your alteration columns as text, as they will not be able to be modeled. Now that we're done with the geology table, we'll move to the contamination table. We can see the values waiting to be imported are numeric. So in this case, we are going to select the numeric data type. Lastly, we have our weathering column. As I mentioned before, I'm going to import this as a category. You'll notice there are little red X's over all of the data tables. Leapfrog validates all the imported data and flags the errors. We will be covering fixing errors in the next video. For now, I'm going to ignore the errors and take a look at the drill hole data. Let's start by dragging these tables in one at a time. Here I can see what I have for my callers. When it comes to the survey table, there's actually nothing to view. If we want to see the downhole trace, we must view one of the interval tables. Once a table is being viewed in the scene, you see it is also available in the scene list. You'll notice in the scene list there are several options available to control the look of the drill holes in the scene window. First, we have the eyeball, which is the invisibility. We have the ability to make the drill holes transparent, make them cylindrical, label the drill holes, and show the legend in scene. We also have these two drop-downs. The first drop-down box shows the object's attributes, giving you different options for displaying the object. For example, the geology table is currently being viewed as simple lith, but it could be changed to view either the strat column of data or flat color. I'm going to change it back to simple lith and look at the next box. The second box allows you to edit the color for the object being viewed. We will address color map functionality in the next video.